Yes, we have Kirti Agarwal here, who recently achieved PMP successfully, and she got above target in all the five domains. Getting above target in all is not that easy. You need a good amount of commitment and good amount of knowledge in a way. Think from the exams perspective, think from a leadership perspective, and she did an amazing job. She has a good amount of experience, but at the same time, her way of looking exams also good. How do I know that? As I see her practice exam, she was consistently above 75. So it's so consistent. Okay, the word consistency is very important. And she showed a good amount of progress in the daily. And also she showed the same in her main exams. So let's listen from her how things went on. So before that, we'll bring up her success here. Okay, here we have her great certificate, which talks about target and all, right? So she works with as a team lead at EY. Good. So Kitty, how do you feel about it? And what's your success formula? Before I go there, congratulations from Sri Learning and team. I know getting PMP is not that easy. It needs a good amount of commitment towards the preparation. And I believe you did a lot of sacrifice, food, sleep, and family functions, and still you are able to do that. It's a good job. So congratulations, and to you, Kitty, do you have any tips to share with me?
First of all, thank you so much, sir, and giving me this opportunity. Like, it's a pleasure to come on on this screen and talking to people, giving the tips to people and helping them in any way that I can possibly do. So yes, definitely coming to it. It was not very easy, I would say, but so it definitely requires a lot of dedication. I think dedication is the main key to it. And honestly, I started preparation somewhere in February. And since then, it was always that, I would dedicate, like, I would study for a week or 2 weeks, and then eventually, because of the work schedule, my work has been really, really hectic and really busy. So I would then eventually stop preparing, give it a gap, and then I even if I used to skip a day, it just used to ultimately happen that I used to end up skipping it for like almost a month. So never, never skip a day. So because if you start skipping one day, you'll be like, let's skip another day, let's skip this, I'll start it from Monday. So I always used to have this thing, especially starting with Monday or maybe first of the month, was one thing that I should never be waiting for that. So the key is that, you should continue and never give a break. And I would probably feel that anybody can crack it. And like, I took a lot of time, but because I was taking a lot of breaks in between, but I feel that, probably a 3 months time or 4 months time is a decent time if you're dedicated, if you're giving the time every day. And ultimately, and I just realized that I'm not able to focus onto anything, like even while I was working. So if I had to give in extra hours, I would always feel that, oh no, I should, rather than, I should close my laptop and start focusing on my studies simultaneously. So I would say that I was not able to concentrate on any of the things. And I was not, even while I was trying to spend my time somewhere else, watching any movies or anything, so it was always on the back of my mind that I have to study, I have to study. So I was not able to enjoy anything at all. So then finally I came to,
PMP is a spoiler for you on your good, what is it, fun time, right? You have to
yeah,
sacrifice.
definitely, definitely. So the solution or the way out to it is like, let's do it and get it done with it. Like,
What's the
absolutely. Now I just don't want it to spoil it anymore, and let me just get done with it. So definitely, and I picked the PMP preparation at the worst time of mine, like where I was even struggling with my office work was a lot really hectic. And luckily, even during the lockdown, I had some domestic helps who could help us through, with all the household. So earlier, I did not really used to have to worry about it. And then just recently, just before like 15 days or 20 days before my exam, so our domestic help also left. So I had to start, and it was like a new thing for me, like not doing, I've never done household. So suddenly I had to start cooking. I had to do the, the house chores. Then I had to manage my office.
I like it. You say suddenly start cooking.
Yeah. Actually, that was because I had to feed my family. Like, now I don't have a cook anymore. So, and then, like, those everything, like, probably last 1 month things happened, and it was For me, I think I haven't, like, just before the exam for 1 month almost, I haven't slept, I would say, like a 6 hours or a 7 hours continuously, because my office was almost like 12 hours that I had to really invest on. So after the office, in between any meetings or in between if I was getting, so for me, like a breather was from my office works to invest. If I take like a break from my office would just to study, like focus on revising some questions or revising some topics. But then also I was having a lot of preparation and planning a day before that, you know, tomorrow these are the things that I have to complete. And I was trying to stick to the schedule, like really strictly that I have to cover these topics. And for me, the sleep pattern was like, you know, that I would sleep for, let's say I would sleep an hour in the evening, like 6 to 7, so that I can be active for like next 5 hours or 6 hours. And then focus on, you know, the work or the preparation, then take like a 2-3 hours sleep and then again start with it, because there were a lot of things going on. And I think the only key to success is definitely regularity. Plus, apart from that is practice. You have to keep practicing questions. Like really, I really felt that, you know, while I was practicing questions, a lot of concepts came became clearer to me while practicing the questions. Like before that, I have studied things, but I could not really relate until I started doing the questions. And so you should do the questions, you should focus on the questions, then you can definitely, it's very, very important to revise each and every question, even it's a correct answer. So for me, it was like, I don't know if it was unusual for me, but then usually for any mock, it used to take 4 hours. But for me to revise the mock used to take 6 hours.
Okay, okay. In fact, people take 2 to 3 days to revise one exam.
Yeah. So like, yeah, 6 hours, I would say, like 6 to 7 hours to revise the exam. But I because I had very limited time and I had actually thought that I have to get it done. So I used to complete my review in next day.
Yep, yep. One thing I found with you is you're pretty fast. It may be your practice exam or your evaluation. You are quick. So how this quick process comes? You focus more, or your reading ability is high from childhood? You read a lot. And
so initially it used to take me a lot more time. And I think the most difficult or the challenging part for me was to sit continuously for 4 hours. Wow. And so, I mean, that's the tip that you also gave me, that, you know, for the mocks, initial mocks, I would always look into my phone in between. If there was any call, I would answer the call also. So, you know, so I would not really complete my mock in 4 hours, or probably the last question was that, you know, I was trying to complete it. But then this is your tip that I should keep my phone in the other room while I'm preparing, or switch it off. So I tried doing that. And while I was trying to do that, I realized that, yeah, I can focus much, much better. And then at the back of my mind, I always had this thing that 4 hours is too hard for me to sit. So I have to get this done as soon as possible.
Yeah, many have this. They ask PMI, why 4 hours? Can't you guys judge me in 1 hour?
Right, exactly. I mean, the 4 hours was the most difficult part for me. And but in the exam, I tried a different strategy wherein, you know, I did not really invest. I did not complete. I invested more time, let's say, you know, a little more than 1 minute on each question. So I had exactly calculated time that, you know, I have to complete before my, you know, the 90th break. So I have to invest like approximately, I think 150 minutes or something.
Approximately 1 minute, 20 seconds goes per question.
Yeah. So I was actually investing. So I had like a same time for, so I complete my last question at the last minute. So, because I realized that, you know, if I take a lot of time in completing earlier, and then if I have to go back and revise, I will take more time. And for me, it doesn't really work when I start revising. If I revise the question, I kind of do it wrong. So if the answer comes to me in the first instance, I know it. Otherwise, it's a fluke.
Okay, okay. Makes point. Yeah, that's great. Good, good. And when you went to the examination, did you found certain area more questions were deep inside, like say?
Oh, yeah. So there were a lot of questions from procurement, and there were a lot of questions from cost management. Uh-huh. So lot of them from cost management, and the hardest part or the challenging part was that, you know, the questions was comparatively smaller, so it was easier to read like a one liner or a two liner, but the options were very tricky. So like the elimination strategy wasn't also working too well because all of the options were really, really close. And then few questions I realized that, you know, it was not that, you know, it had a right answer, but you know, the strategy of the best answer. So I mean, while I was reading the questions, the answer, the options, I felt that none of them is right, none of them really fits here. But right. then you know, you have to pick the best option out of them.
Got you. You know, one critical thing about the PMP exam is questions will be very small.
And right.
It will have information as you need there. Usually we prepare with the bigger questions because bigger questions exactly. will have a good amount of story. You get the story and then you answer it. Here,
exactly.
Crisp two lines, you have to get the content.
Sometimes exactly.
Sometimes we get a doubt. Is this question that's it or something more this guy's missed out? Right.
I think that's one thing that I was actually, you know, I had this doubt, and I, you know, you clarified that, and I, even if some questions are going to be direct, so don't think that, you know, it's something that you are doing wrong. It's okay. They might give you some direct questions as well, but yeah, there were few direct questions, but more were like, that they had, the options were actually bigger than the question.
Right. Good. And many of them have a question. Do we get ITTO, inputs, tools and techniques?
Yes, definitely. So it's not that, you know, it will come directly that, you know, what is the next, what is the ITTO. But then let's say that, you know, there's a question that talks about that, you know, you are managing a scope or something, or you are creating the decomposition we are doing. So, you know, just with the word of decomposition, you might have to run through your brain that, okay, if it's a decomposition, then probably we must be in the planning phase. And right. then within the planning phase, we could be in the scope management. So right. this is that, like, you need to, so that will give you, and, you know, then if you have other options, that those are for execution or maybe some other, this thing, process group or knowledge area. So you would know that, you know, those cannot be the correct answers because those will be eliminated, because right now you are in the planning phase, because if it's into decomposition, so you cannot, you don't have to create like a change request at the moment.
Makes sense. Perfect. Great. Hey, one other thing, when you're writing examination, did you start with feeling that this exam is a smooth, I'm sure it'll clear this?
No. Not at all. So when I actually, so you've told me that, you know, when you will know that you've cleared the exam, when you see congratulations, a big congratulation will come on your screen. And I'm telling you a real incident. And I saw that, you know, it was not a big congratulation. It was like just a small congratulation followed by a big paragraph. And I'm like, is it that they are just congratulating me because I completed my exam? Or is it that I've passed the exam? I'm not sure what has really happened.
For us, a big event. The moment you clear, we expect a big level of 100 people standing up and applauding.
Hey, yeah, exactly. And
congratulations, thanks, you did a good job.
Huh, exactly. And then I was like, I don't know. Then when I logged in and saw my score, and it was all above target. So for a minute, I thought that, you know, this is just a sample report that they are throwing, that, you know, this is how you're going to get your result. And when I saw that, no, it's Kriti Agarwal, it's my scorecard. So I was like, wow, that's me.
So when you click the last button, did you hear your heartbeat?
Yes, a lot. And definitely, one of the tip that I really would want to give to people is that I would encourage that we should go to the center and give the exam. Because the major challenge that I had was because sitting just straight for 4 hours was very, very difficult. And while I, you know, I realized that I'm running out of time. So I don't know, I have this kind of thing that, you know, I start lip reading my question, because whenever you are in a rush, you kind of start lip reading. And even if I'm not loud enough, but my lips will certainly, you know, there will be a movement. So I got a, you know, this message warning, kind of, I would say, from this thing examiner that, you know, you should you should stop lip reading, otherwise I'll have to cancel your exam. And then sitting there continuously, like I did not realize that I suddenly kept my, unconsciously I kept my, you know, hand on my mouth. And the things that I've really learned that, you know, I should not be doing, I was unconsciously doing all of them. So probably had it been another time, I don't know if they would have really canceled. And then in between also it happened that, you know, but luckily I didn't go in the panic mode, because you warned me about it already, that you know, suddenly I think a examiner changed, you know, there was some other person, and then later on it changed, and then they pinged me in between. So while they were pinging, so the screen would pop up, but probably the question used to take, or whatever the chat was, chat message used to take almost a 30-second or 40-second to come up. So in that manner, I was wasting my time, I realized. And, you know, you kind of get distracted. And, you know, so once they asked me that, you know, I show me the screen around. So, and I was like, how am I supposed to show my, like, my laptop is not revolving, that I can just turn around. So I was like, I took the laptop and turned it around in the room. And then obviously that kind of scared me, that, you know, why are they questioning? Like, it happens. It's just general thing that you will happen, that, you know, why are they asking me? Why are they questioning me? Kind of a thing I happened.
In the middle of the exam? Did they ask
you? Yeah, yeah. In the middle of the exam.
They asked you to take the laptop and show the room?
Yes. They asked me to show the surrounding. So, I mean, I was like, how am I supposed to even show the surrounding? And I just had to... I was like, how am I supposed to show this? So I picked up my laptop and turned it around. So that kind of wasted, and I would say that really distracted me for almost 5 minutes, that, you know, what has happened? Why is he asking me to do that?
Yep,
and yep. And then second time again it happened, then definitely they were pinging me that, you know, you should not lip read. Then second time it happened that, you know, they told me that I am not able to see your video. But then, I mean, had it been a normal situation, I would have really panicked that it's my video is on and I'm not doing anything. But then you warned me that, you know, it happens sometimes that they come back and they say that, you know, the video is not available. So I told them that I can see my video out there. I don't know what's wrong that you're not able to see it. So they told me, okay, let me restart. And
the point is, they do check, is this person there? There are a lot of forgeries try to happen, keep the record there, kind of thing. They want to see, is it the same person sitting in front of the cam? And in between, they want to see the room so that you are not reading the question to somebody in front of you.
Right.
Kind of thing. But I know this point is distractive. You will be in a rhythm of answering questions.
When exactly.
You lose a track of it. That's a problem.
And yeah, I mean, more than distraction, like, you know, it just keeps a thought comes in your mind that are they really doubting me, or, you know, yeah, what will happen next? Are they even convinced with whatever I've given the answer? So then they said that, okay, I'll have to restart your test. So, and you will, you know, it will start from wherever you've left. So again, you know, that thing kind of distracted me, that my exam got closed and then it suddenly opened. So all the time that I've invested already in reading that question, I would say that, you know, that was kind of lost. So these things were a little distracting. And then definitely, like, you know, when you're in the exam, it will happen. Like, if you're sitting for 4 hours, you just cannot stay still. Like, you would want to move your hand a bit, or you would want to move your feet a bit. But then I could not do that. Like, I just had to look straight. So I just had to look straight onto my this thing. And usually I used to give, I don't know, like, it was just my personal thing. Usually I used to give my mock exams while sitting on my bed. So, and I was most comfortable with that. And I tried to follow the same strategy. But then I did not realize while giving the mock that, you know, I should keep the laptop as it is. Like, in between the mock exams, I used to keep moving the laptop and, you know, keep changing position. Yeah. Exactly. So I could not do that. So that was like, literally my feet were like, I want to be moved. So the last question while I was ending, rather than, you know, ending the exam and being curious about the result, I was more like, I need to move my feet. I cannot, it's hurting now.
Oh my God. So much pressure, right? 4 hours, sit like a robot.
Exactly, exactly. And then, you know, you just have to look straight into your camera, like, and I think that was probably the only thing that I felt that, you know, did not, because I was just, even while I was lip reading or everything, so I was just looking straight into the camera.
Got you. I know this is not there in center. Center, you have a freedom of maybe stretching out. At least you can stand up.
Exactly.
Take one more break if you want. I know one break is allowed. One more break, if you can go. Still, it is not a problem. Those things not available at the home based. Yeah, some problems are there. Good. Yeah. And did you take a break, that 10 minutes break? Did you utilize it?
Oh, no. I did not. So I just got up. I just drank water and I was back in the 8th minute.
Yeah, fine. That's it. One break you used it. That is a break.
8 minutes, as in like I was back after 2 minutes. Yeah.
2 minutes. That's it.
Yeah.
That time you had to use it properly, because 10 minutes given. This 8 minutes probably you could have walked sometime, relax yourself, stretch yourself. This was not there beginning of this year, where when I was writing examination those days, it will be like 4 hours continuous same place. So stressful, right? So you need some break to at least go for your refreshment and come back. That's very important.
I was just scared that, you know, I might be late, or like even those 2 minutes seemed to be 10 minutes for me. And when I came back, I was like, oh, it's, I still have like almost 8 minutes left. I'm like, let's get started and let's get done with it.
Close it. I have to go and watch Netflix.
Yeah, exactly. Just close it. And so I scheduled my exam at like 6 a.m. And I had like a meeting scheduled at 11 a.m. So I was like, I have a meeting. I cannot run late. I did not take an off from work.
You can understand how packed your days are. Well, good. First of all, thanks a lot for coming up and to give some tips like this, because I know it's not easy to come back and tell this is what happened. Once you count it, you feel that it's over. It's over. That's it. Don't ask me.
Yeah. Anything.
Right. It takes some heart to come back and talk, because there are many people preparing for it. Not only this examination, any examination. They may not know where to start. One important tip what I understood from you is, don't wait for a particular day to start.
Exactly.
I like that sentence probably. Maybe I will take it personally. Don't look for a day to start. Start right now. right now. So right. I think that's your main secret of your success, that it makes you to move forward. I know at the young age, you achieved a lot of stuff at the leadership track. And let this PMP set you more high and go higher in your career and in personal, professional life, let you succeed more. Soon we'll see you as a Kirti CEO, right?
Sure.
Good wishes. And thanks a lot for all your tips here. And once again, congratulations for being PMP. Now you can sleep well, eat well, and also you can watch a lot of videos. But back up, it'll tell that whatever I learned, I have to materialize it. I have to use it, right? So the next stage will be like marketing it and also using it in our day-to-day life. That's very
absolutely
important. Absolutely. And you have to use it in your project.
Yeah, I think the best thing that really worked for me was I had listed out the things that what I will do after the exam. how I'm going to reward myself after clearing the exam. And definitely thanks a lot to you, so that, you know, I think those last days coaching and guidance was very, very much needed, because I wasn't sure. And I think nobody is very sure that, you know, how prepared you are. But then definitely just one advice to everybody, just don't jump into it. I would say that, you know, you should consult somebody, you know, or reach out to Sriram sir, and, you know, probably see and analyze your result, or consult somebody who has a good experience of the exam or PMP, so that, you know, you can check that, you know, are you ready for the exam or not, because it's a big cost involved, and then obviously you've invested a lot of time already. So just for that last limit thing, we don't want to miss the exam.
Well said. I know. Even though we read all, but not sure, am I ready? So a small help then. That's good. Fantastic. Great. Keep shining and be top 2% all the time in your personal and professional life, right? Good wishes, and thanks for coming up here.
Thank you so much, sir. Goodbye.